Hello, my name is Svetlana. I want to tell you some secrets about plants growing in your tank. Of course, it's different conditions can be different plants like different conditions. But for success in aquarium to growing plants, there is main things that you have to follow or try to follow maximally to help your plants. First one, it's better if you start your tank buy first very strong plants who will survive in difficult conditions. For example, you have to ask people who selling plants how strong they are, how they surviving in new conditions. Because some plants is very soft and very gentle. If you put them to aquarium with little bit different conditions, they can die just from shock, from transferring from one aquarium to another one. Okay, maybe they will not die, but they will feel no good. At the start, just try simple ones. Okay, second one, good soil. It's good gravel or something, but helping your plants to grow. For example, in my this big tank, I have a little bit big gravel. Little bit bigger because there is bigger plants and they're growing bigger because there is lots of space, more lights, and they okay to have good roots to keeping themselves very good. In a small tank I have smaller soil, but if I put before I've been putting a little bit like sand, and that was not okay because in a sand not enough circulation inside, and roots not always feel good from that. If you not clean your tank every day, it's not good for fish and for plants. And if you not clean that often, it can be a little bit not okay smell because there is not enough circulation between that small parts, particles or the sand. I think gravel have to be somewhere in the middle, not too big and not too small. Okay. And third one, it's very important what fish doing for the plants. They create natural fertilizer by their vast. They just making something, eating, make caca, and that helping your plants growing. This is very important for good ecosystem, and plants can absorb that and grow. Of course, you anyway need to clean your tank, but the plants also helping to make that filtration. It's natural filtration. If you put some really good filters, maybe your plants will not have enough food. Maybe have, it depends. All tanks is different, all situations is different. For example, my tank don't need anything. They have fish, plants, no nothing. No aeration, no filtration, nothing. It's just ecosystem, but it's making that good, you know. I just maybe someone will not believe me, but it's true. If you make your ecosystem in a tank correctly, you don't need anything. It's just natural things. But with small tanks it's more difficult because it's very easy to overfeed fish and make your water smelly and make bed for plants and for fish, and both can die. In big aquarium, it's easy to keep natural ecosystem, what I actually do. Number five, it's carbon dioxide. Maybe my pronunciation not correct, but I really don't know how to pronounce in English. But this one, someone buying special systems who dropping that for the plants. But you know, if you don't have aeration and fish breeding, and they just make that when they breed out, they just give for plants that carbon dioxide, and usually it's enough for plants to have that like a food, to have that to absorb and to grow. Number six, very important things in your tank, it's lights. Lights have to be enough bright, enough good for plants. I did one mistake when I bought the lamp. I changed my lamp and I think it will be better. It will be like less electricity but more brighter. You know what happening? My plants start dying, slowly dying. First I can see in the small plants they can be like not okay. In the big plants it's not seems because they longer surviving. They just processes going longer in that plants. But when I see my small plants start dying, I'm running again to big shop to buy big lamp again with normal lights, not some LED who giving too much lights but actually don't give anything what's necessary for the plants. You have to ask in a shop what lamps is better for the plants, how it will help them to grow. Number seven, if you just starting your tank, it's everything new for your aquarium and for plants and for fish. There is not yet good ecosystem. There is not good vast from the fish, not enough nutrients for the plants. And they can suffer in because they, first, because they're moving, second, because there is no food for them. Okay, if you put good lights, maybe it will help them to adopt better, to make that ecosystem quicker. But it's always big challenge for plants and for fish. New tank, it's new tank. Just you have to try, you have to be careful. Sometimes you need to get some advice in a fish shop how to handle that problem faster. Number eight, most of people who care about aquariums, they thinking very important to clean the tank very often. It's necessary to clean if you see the algae too much and it's like dark things on the ground. Yes, you need to remove that, of course. But if they do it too often and they disturbing plants a lot all the time, it's also no good. No good for fish, not good for plants. That's because many experienced aquariumists, they never recommend you to clean your tank completely, to remove all plants, to put new everything, you know. No, you don't have to clean your tank perfectly. No, you have to clean just what is necessary to remove, not just like cleaning exactly. If you see around the plants a little bit vast or something, you can around a little bit clean, but better not touch the plants. They don't like it, they're not enjoying, they can suffer from this. First you're removing food from them, second you're disturbing them. And last one, it's problem of aeration. Some aquariums, they put a lots of bubbles or a lots of filtration. Sometimes you can see how fish even suffering. They can't stand on one place, they just have to fight with that big stream, you know. They don't feel good because they always need to fight with something. They don't feel comfortable in that conditions. And also it's same for plants. How they holding in the soil, but they all the time like this. It's very crazy for them. Very difficult to survive if it's always something disturbing you. But that is not main problem, because you give a lots of oxygen to your tank, does mean it's less carbon dioxide, does mean your plant suffering from not enough what they need to absorb. And of course, they can die because it's too much oxygen, what is good for fish, but not very good for plants. Just be careful in that balance. Never put too much aeration. Why my tank survive without it at all? Because they have plenty of plants, and plants giving natural oxygen. Yeah, and fish have enough. I'm just never put too much fish. You have to find out how many fish it's okay to keep in the tank without aeration. I actually tried to find in a Google in English, but it's not easy to find. Lots of companies try to sell aeration system, cleaning systems, filtration and everything. That's because nobody don't put information about how many fish can live in a tank in natural ecosystem without aeration and without any cleaning things. In Russian websites I can find it, and probably I will write below the video. Maybe I will find in English and I put some links if I will find. I'm not promised because it's a little bit difficult. Actually, Russian people, they thinking how to use less electricity, how to make fish feel better, but without any expensive things. Yeah, Russian people too much think about it. Okay, and that was the main things why plants not surviving. Sometimes, I don't know why, but in aquarium is some not good ecosystem happening. Like you put your plants and plants very quick dying from nothing. There is fish, there is very good, but something in the water make that plants dying. I didn't find out yet what is it, but sometimes really for example, my girlfriend, she have a small fish tank, and I still can't understand why her plants not growing. She have enough lights, she have enough food, fish, everything. But I give my plants from my good tank to her, and there they dying. And I'm give again, and it's again dying. That video looking some specialists who know the reason about it, and there is like no reason what I can understand. If somebody know what else can disturb plants from growing, please write me in the comments. I will be very appreciate. Thank you. Have a good day. All the best. Bye bye.